Well, good win there for Elliot Matthews. Our next fight is six rounds of cruiserweight between Darius Skop and Gyorgy Nagy. We could just squeeze that one in before the main event, given that that fight went short. Let's now go over to our MC, Mark Schmidt.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now have an international contest. Please join me in welcoming in from Tolna in Hungary, Gyorgy Novak.
Well, Gyorgy Novak, one of a number of fighters who's travelled over from Hungary tonight. 12 fights, 8 wins and 4 defeats. 4 of those 8 wins have come by way of knockout. Difficult to make too much of his record, difficult to glean too much from it. We shall see what he's got against Darius Skop.
And please welcome his opponent from Oxfordshire via Poland, Darius Skop.
Well, Darius Skop has brought some support, fighting out of Didcot by way of Poland. 4 wins and no defeats so far, 2 of those wins coming by way of knockout. He says that by the end of 2016 he wants to be in the top 30 of the world rankings. He asked actually to be matched tougher after his June fight against Haider Sadiq. It was a very straightforward victory. So Mickey Elliott has found him Gyorgy Novak, somewhat, as I say, of an unknown quantity. And so Macaronelli has stopped Novak in good fashion. Skop says this fight won't last a couple of rounds. We shall see.
This is a cruiserweight contest of 6 3-minute rounds. Introducing in the blue corner, wearing the white shorts with the red trim. Weighing in today at 13 stone, 3 pounds and 1 ounce. With a record of 8 victories, 4 inside the distance from 12 professional contests from Tolna in Hungary, Gyorgy Novak. And his opponent across the ring in the red corner, wearing the black trunks with the gold trim. Weighing in today at 14 stone, 3 pounds and 1 ounce. With a record of 4 victories, 2 inside the contest distance from 4 professional contests. From Oxfordshire, Darius Skop. Your referee, Robert Williams from Watford. Your timekeeper, Bob Edgeworth from Bromley. This is a cruiserweight contest of 6 3-minute rounds.
Okay, ladies, obey my commands. In the event of a knockdown, the fighter standing will go to the furthest neutral corner and stay there. Defend yourself at all times. Touch gloves.
Good luck. Bob Williams, the referee for this one. 6 rounds of cruiserweight. Darius Skop in the black shorts. Gyorgy Novak in the red and white. Had to have a little skip of the weigh-in yesterday. Skop came in just slightly heavy. Had to get rid of about a pound. Saw him outside the gym, just down by the water at the Limehouse Marina. All togged up with a skipping rope out, drawing some fairly curious glances from the odd passerby. Novak settling into that southpaw stance. Skop looking to try and make a patient start here. Just wants to try and have a look at his opponent and see what he's got. Tries to come in behind that jab. Skop marauds forward with a backhand. It's not often that you find a fighter, Billy, who asks his manager to match him tougher at an early stage of his career. It's quite unusual.
It's the way forward. We all want to fight the best out there. Get amongst the best, be the best. We all have big ambitions. The Iceman, can he pull it off tonight? Can he put him on ice tonight?
Well, comes in with a right hand there, and then Novak was made to miss with a wild swinging left. Cruiserweight division, an interesting one, as one as the advertising Toblerone just spills onto our desk. Obel McKenzie fighting for a world title tonight, just travelled away to Argentina at, I think, about 11 days notice it was in the end, to have a crack at the IBF title. The Skop just catches Novak with a right hand there. Obel McKenzie, a London-based fighter these days, trains down at the Peacock in Canning Down. Magnificent, busy gym. In a real boxing heartland of the country, as the, again, the advertising horn comes crashing down as Novak, which is knocked into the ropes. He did go down, he did drop a knee, so the referee just giving the count. Again, Skop just tries to come in with the right hand here. He did predict, as I said, right at the very start that this wouldn't go more than two rounds, and he may well be proved to be right. Likes that left hand, Billy, doesn't he? But he doesn't really land it.
No, it's a bit wild. It's like he's bowling. It's like he's playing cricket.
Oh, Skop landing some meaningful blows on the ropes. Right above us, just boring in with a head there. I think he lost balance slightly in towards the corner.
Two big guys, lots of weight.
Well, it looks like Novak is going to make it through this first round. I wasn't absolutely sure about that about 30, 40 seconds ago. Maybe the work rate is slightly diminished from Skop right at the very end of this opening 3 minutes. It'll be a 10-8 round for the man from Didcot.
Well, into the second round of this fight, scheduled with six at cruiserweight. Darius Skop in the black has had Gyorgy Novak over once in that first round. Again, Novak looks for that wild swinging left hand. It's not getting any closer to the target. And it just leaves him open every time he misses with it. Skop just forced back towards the ropes there, though, manages to turn his man. You sparred with some heavier fighters back in the day, didn't you? Get in with Dennis Andrews
stage? They're big guys. These are big guys. Yeah, Dennis Andrews, what a fighter. He was like granite trying to move him. It was impossible for a little kid like me.
Well, you've been giving away a fair amount of weight.
Absolutely.
Scott, just drop that left hand.
The work rate's dropped off.
Skop just trying to pull that right hand up from waist height almost to try and clip Novak around the side of the head. Novak just dipped in. The heads almost came together. Chopping overhand right there from Novak, doesn't land. Well,
Maybe just caught with the right hand slightly there, Novak. Yeah. He looked slightly unsteady, and Skop himself, as he came in, just slipped and then fell back onto his heels as he was looking to try and close in and close the show, I think, really, with the right hand jabs to the body. Novak does what he needs to do there. He just ties his man up and buys himself just a little bit of time. Right hand just didn't quite reach. Does tend to wander in behind that right hand, just follow it in at times, Skop, but Novak isn't really capable of countering it, and he caught a left hand there again, Novak, as well. Heading in towards the last 30 seconds of this round. He's just been bullied, Novak, at the minute, really, isn't he?
He is. He's getting worked over. He's bowling a few shots in, but none of them are really getting through.
Well, final few seconds of the second round, and another left hand just caught Novak. Slightly off balance there from Skop. I don't think it was a really serious blow, as both boxers just head back towards their corners. Crowd in full anticipation of the headline fight we've got coming up after this one for the Southern Area Super Middleweight title between Darrell Williams and Richard Horton. Two London fighters. They'll be waiting nervously, anxiously backstage at the moment. Skop doesn't really sustain it for 3 minutes of a round, does he? Plenty of fighters don't, but just fights in bursts and not really enough concerted pressure, maybe.
3 minutes is a long time in there, and it's if he could just keep that work rate up, he could get rid of this guy. He calls himself the Iceman. Let's see if he can pull it off.
Corners, 10 seconds. Second vote, round three.
Skop at the start of the third round just looks for that 1-2. Novak just coming in behind the left hand, hasn't really managed to establish that southpaw job. Skop again just walks through it, really, trying to get into the inside. In terms of reach, it's Novak really who's got the slight advantage. Referee just having a word with both of them. Very experienced referee, Bob Williams, in the Southern Area circuit. Looking to measure that right hand. He just gets a little bit too close at times, Skop Billy, and just smothers his own work.
Yeah, he's too close, can't get the shot in. Needs to find his distance so he can connect. He's looking.
Some blood coming from the nose of Novak. Quite an awkward opponent, Novak, though. That long reach, those long arms can make him slightly difficult to get to.
Southpaw, awkward. He's leaning in.
But this is all part of it, isn't it? Trying to work an opponent out as you go along, trying to adjust your styling. Maybe just slightly lost his footing there, and more blood coming from the nose just streaming down either side of his mouth. Both fighters have had a slight problem with that bit of the canvas in the last couple of rounds, just losing their footing briefly. And again, he just dips there as Skop's trying to come in. Makes it almost impossible for Darius Skop to find the target. Decent looking left hand there from Novak. Landed to the head, then one to the body. Nothing on that left hook there from Skop, an arm punch really, nothing more. Heading towards the final 10 seconds of the third round, scheduled for six. the cruiserweight. And as we head to the bell, it's another round in the bank for Darius Skop. Well, into the second half of this contest, a cruiserweight between Darius Skop in the black trunks and Gyorgy Novak in the red and white. Skop has dominated so far. Novak, who was down in the first round, not heavily, but that would have been a 10-8 round, so a couple of 10-9s and a 10-8 in Skop's favour so far. What more does he need to do, Billy Skop, when you look at him? You've seen these first three rounds. What more does he need to do just to really...
I think he needs to tighten himself up and get beyond the jab again. Okay, I keep mentioning the jab. Not many fighters use the jab and capitalise and really work the jab. The canvas looks a bit slippery. They've had a few problems.
Let's go with another wild left hand there, Novak. And it looks like he's come to throw some leather in this fourth round. Wild swing to the left and the right, sailed past the head of Darius Skop. Referee just... having a quick chat with Novak about the use of the head there.
Yep, the referee Bob Williams giving him some stern words.
Novak looking for a left to the body. Blood still coming from the nose there of Novak, but not particularly freely. A smearing left hand there for the first time, really. Got through. It didn't make any solid contact, but it just clipped Skop, and he's got to be careful as he maybe gets a little bit more tired, but he doesn't walk onto one. He's been barreled back towards the ropes there as well. He's having a better round here, Novak. Well, the Camden Centre... nice and full. People anticipating that main event for the Southern Area Super Middleweight title. Darrell Williams and Richard Horton will bring plenty of supporters. Got a bit heated with the weigh-in yesterday. Mickey Elliott had a step in between them, and it continued as well when the cameras were turned off a little bit later on. So no love lost between those two when they get into the ring later on tonight. Again, a marauding attack there from Novak. Skop looking for that 1-2. He's only done that on a couple of occasions in the fight so far. Slightly better round, I would say, that from the man in the corner away to our right-hand side, Gyorgy Novak.
Absolutely, yeah. He's bowling a few over. He's caught him a couple of times, but like you said, nothing really of any substance. He's getting tired. It's hard in there. It's a hard night's work for both of them. But it's great to have boxing here at London again. Brilliant.
You think about these two fellas who are waiting in the changing rooms just over our left shoulder up the stairs to come into the ring for this Southern Area title, Darrell Williams and Richard Horn. How are they feeling at the minute? I remember reading about you describing the scene when you were fighting for your British title, Commonwealth title, I think, as well, against Carl Crooks at the Royal Albert Hall, changing rooms below the arena, like the Coliseum. You could hear the crowd, you could hear it bubbling up. What are they going through now?
And it's all about what I call mental boxing. It's those last minutes leading up to the... You get the knock on the door, walking out into the arena. That's where fights could be won and lost. Mental boxing, that's what it's all about.
Well, they'll be going through their final preparations. Getting a bit of a sweat on. The hands will have been wrapped, gloved up, ready to go. Still some boxing left in this fight, those six rounds. This is scheduled for at cruiserweight. Darius Skop in the black, Gyorgy Novak in the red and white. Relatively comfortable for Skop so far. Novak did better in that last round. I said standing room only earlier on, and I wasn't joking. You see the audience towards the back there. Very good view inside the Camden Centre, wherever you are. It's a nice tight little space up on the balconies as well. Just a little bit of tape coming loose from the glove of Novak there. Fighting at the Royal Albert Hall must have been absolutely incredible. I mean, boxing fans of a slightly older vintage will remember it. I include myself in that. It's not really happened all that recently. I think they tried, but the local residents just won't have it. But you go into that arena, I've been there for other events, and yeah, it is, the Coliseum is the right word. It's an amphitheatre.
It is amazing. My friend Paul Winter, he talks about it. He says one of the best venues that he's been in. And for me, as a fighter, to box in the Royal Albert Hall, to be top of the bill, it's just a dream come true. Incredible experience. Especially fighting for championships.
Well, a point being taken away from Gyorgy Novak here by referee Bob Williams. And a point being taken away from Darius Skop as well. So both of these two infringing, the referee deciding that he'd had enough of it. And just telling them both to keep it clean. Nice right hand there from Novak, just launched.
And a bit of a clash of heads. Bob Williams doing a good job. He's a great ambassador for a charity called Box Clever, getting kids off the street into gyms, into clubs. He's got a hard night's work in there, Bob.
Well, that's a huge role that boxing plays, isn't it, in the community, boxing clubs. And maybe don't get the publicity they deserve.
Yeah, boxing clubs are a great charity, kids off the street. It's brilliant. I'm involved in it, and it's amazing what they're up to and what they're doing. Give kids an identity, gets them off the street, something to do, something to focus on. They get coached, they get trained, they work with others. There's lots of life lessons in the boxing ring.
We're heading towards the closing stages of the fifth round. Been an untidy round, this one. Both of these two, I think, just starting to feel the effects. A little bit tired. Mouths hanging open and just sucking the air in. Well, the referee's called the timeout again here. Well, Bob Williams just warning Novak about holding. He's quite strict, Bob Williams. He won't be slow to throw Novak out here if he feels that he's constantly infringing. Again, just tying Skop up towards the end of the round there. Novak launched a few punches of his own and then just wandered onto the inside as the bell goes at the end of the fifth. Well, two fighters come to the centre of the ring and touch gloves. This is the sixth and final round at cruiserweight. Darius Skop predicted that this fight wouldn't last two rounds. He was right. It looks like it's going to last six. He was looking for the finish inside the first 6 minutes. It hasn't come. He did knock Gyorgy Novak down early in the fight, but it wasn't a heavy knockdown. He's not really been able to follow it up, and Novak has never looked in any real trouble in there. Some blood has come from the nose, but other than that, he's managed to negotiate his way through these rounds pretty successfully. Again, the referee just separating these two. Right hand there from Skop just got through and caught Novak. And they're both looking pretty weary in there, Bill, I think, aren't they, by now?
They are. Six three-minute rounds. That's a hard night's work. Big guys, a lot of leaning, a lot of grappling. That's exhausting in itself when you're hanging on. It's got a bit messy at times. Bob Williams has had a tough night as well. He's had to work for his money.
Well, it's underestimated the physicality of the role of the referee sometimes, because they have to get in between these two big men and separate them. Read about referees and the fitness regimes they undertake. Old referees like Arthur McCante kept refereeing until he was about 80 years old. Mickey Van still going.
Yep, I know Bob's in training for the London Marathon next year. Raising money for Box Clever.
Well, that is a serious undertaking. Not something I've ever been tempted by, I must confess.
Done it once. Once was enough.
Well, that's the Novak corner. And their man is going to successfully see his way through to the final bell. Greg Steen, the manager of Richard Horton, just sat next to Mark Tibbs on the far side of the ring there. Maybe a few butterflies for him. Very, very experienced manager, of course. Guided Dennis Andrews to his world title, but still beat. Very keen to see his man win the Southern Air. Another point being taken from Novak for holding, just trapping that arm of Skop. And a point being taken from Skop as well. So an action replay, really, of the earlier action taken by Bob Williams. Well, final few seconds. It's been a messy fight. It's been an untidy one. But Darius Skop, I think, is going to get another win on his record. He wanted to be tested. And he has been provided with a test here. Just a bit of blood again coming from the nose there of Novak. It's just been seeping out through the course of the fight. Nothing to unduly concern him. As the bell goes at the end of the sixth and final round, an embrace between these two. Well, just octopus arms there, just flying in as these two tried to get to grips with each other. It wasn't easy. Knockdown came for Skop in the second round, I think. And just as he tried to close in there, he just slipped on the canvas. Difficult for Skop, really, to measure an opponent like Novak. He was difficult to find with that backhand that he did seem to favour. An awkward opponent, an awkward fight, really.
Yeah, and he's got to work, he's got to learn how to gauge his distance. He got a bit scrappy at times. Now, if he wants to get himself in a top 30 ranking, that's something he needs to work on.
Well, that was his plan. Top 30 in the world rankings by the end of 2016. He's got some way to go to achieve that, I would say.
Where is he now, do we know?
well, some distance outside of that. I think it's a bit of a challenge for him to make that. It's all about setting yourself targets, though, of course.
Absolutely. And it's a dream to get into the top 10. That is any fighter's dream.
And the MC now just waiting for Bob Williams to hand over his scorecard. And the two fighters, I think, will be called to the centre of the ring shortly, and we'll get the final result.
Ladies and gentlemen, after six rounds of a cruiserweight action, referee Williams scores the contest 56 points to 54 points to your winner and still unbeaten from Oxfordshire, Darius Skop! And your appreciation, please, for Gyorgy Novak.
Well, Darrell Williams against Richard Horner for the Southern Area Super Middleweight title on its way next.